A fascinating eye-catcher in any aquarium. Mysterious superheroes for scientists. And a healthy, and some say, delicious food. They have no brain, consist of more than 98% water, live for just about 1 year, and yet they're full of surprises. Jellyfish. In Denmark, we meet the coordinator of the global jellyfish research project Go Jelly, Jamile Javidpour. It's thanks to her that we might be able to use jellyfish in the future as food, microplastic filters, medicine, and more. She takes our editor Matthias on a jellyfish hunt.
If you see jellyfish, we can stop there.
The fact that researchers around the world are interested in these creatures right now is no coincidence.
We have problems in some areas anyway with the amount of jellyfish that show up every year, but are also there in large numbers at once. You can ignore it, but you can also think of it as a win-win situation.
In some regions, jellyfish numbers have actually increased dramatically. Oh, there are loads here! For her research work, the biologist catches a few specimens today. Whoa, it's slippery! That's a big one. One of the reasons for the many jellyfish in our seas is climate change. Warmer water makes the jellyfish grow faster. This is one of the reasons why in some regions, huge swarms of jellyfish develop within a very short time, so-called jellyfish blooms.
Especially in the area we're in now, you'll find 200 to 300 individuals per cubic meter almost every year. That is the bloom. Meaning in 1 cubic meter, 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, you see 300 of them, and that's the bloom.
And in large groups, the little creature has great power. There have already been several incidents involving jellyfish in nuclear power plants, for example. Swarms of jellyfish get into the power plant's cooling systems with the seawater, leading to shutdowns. In 2006, jellyfish even put the aircraft carrier USS Ronald Reagan out of action. The giant 300-meter warship was brought to a standstill by slimy seawater. Maybe eating them is a solution. At ISPA, the Italian Research Institute for Food Production, Antonella Leoni's team is developing methods to put the jellyfish on our plates. Can I touch it?
Can I touch it?
Yeah. Oh, it's slimy. That's exactly how we see jellyfish. They're so slimy, the way they lie around when you're walking on the beach. And I can't really imagine eating them in any way at all. But it looks really cool. Unprocessed jellyfish cannot be stored. It just decomposes into jellyfish slime and is then inedible. Researchers are therefore working on ways to preserve it. The process is simple, inexpensive, and it could work on a larger scale in the future. The jellyfish is washed in water in several stages. This gets rid of the slime, which is not only, well, slimy, but also contains bacteria. Then the jellyfish are soaked in a salt solution. This preserves them and reduces the amount of water in the jellyfish. After 5 to 10 days, the Mediterranean jellyfish is ready to be processed, or semi-processed.
Jellyfish can be harvested and captured by considering their presence inside the sea and respecting their the equilibrium in the sea. I think that as a semi-finished product stored in the freezer, they can be sold.
But what does jellyfish taste like? Our editor makes his way to Chef Fabiano Viva.
What have you prepared for us?
Jellyfish.
Jellyfish. Okay, amazing.
One new recipe.
Okay.
But for you, very simple recipe.
And a typically German recipe at that, because the dish Fabiano has prepared is a jellyfish
Spitzel.
Schnitzel?
Schnitzel, like schnitzel. Egg, flour. To cook, prepare some recipe of jellyfish raw is very difficult. But when jellyfish is cooked like this, you can make everything.
Right.
Roasted, fried.
So, first of all, the jellyfish has to be boiled. It loses water in the process. And because it consists almost entirely of water, it shrinks quite a lot during the process. Now the jellyfish can be processed further. And in the case of the jellyfish schnitzel, this means breading, then frying it in oil. Deep fried jellyfish. And? It's actually quite cool. The consistency is not as slimy as I'd imagined. It's more firm to the bite, like raw fish, and not quite as rubbery as octopus rings, which I don't like so much. It's quite tasty. Tastes very fresh. Bit like the sea.
It's really good.
To serve the meat and the fish like now in the future will be impossible for the world.
Okay.
So the human race needs some alternative food, and jellyfish can be the alternative food of the future.
Jellyfish is actually a really healthy food. It contains a lot of protein, antioxidants, and anti-inflammatory substances. But that's not all. One substance in jellyfish is of great interest for the cosmetics industry and even for medicine. Jellyfish collagen, a protein. It operates in the watery jellyfish as a support material. After all, it has no skeleton. This ability to bind liquid is in great demand in the beauty industry. It prevents the skin from drying out and is found in anti-wrinkle creams. And in medicine? Here, research is being done on helping damaged human cartilage to grow back faster using jellyfish collagen. Let's stay with medical research. An Italian biologist, Antonella Leoni, is also pinning her hopes on the jellyfish in the fight against cancer. For her experiments, the scientist uses a multi-stage process to extract a concentrate from the jellyfish.
Apart from protein and salts, there is a small amount of bioactive compounds that in several cases for several species like jellyfish that contain microalgae, this bioactive compound coming from the macroalgae, and they can have a very important activities.
Among other things, the researcher is investigating how the jellyfish concentrate affects cancer cells. The result is surprising.
So the final effect that is that jellyfish increase the die of cancer cell.
There's still a long way to go before we have a finished medicine, but the first step has been taken. A very different property of the jellyfish has particularly surprised marine biologist Jamile Javidpour, namely the ability of jellyfish slime to bind the smallest particles from the sea, such as microplastics.
I was very surprised when I saw that jellyfish mucus is almost 100% capable of absorbing small particles. 100% is a lot, and you don't need a large amount. It only takes a few milliliters to absorb a few hundred plastic particles.
Researchers want to harness this ability. They are working on water filters made from jellyfish slime. The place they want to use them is sewage treatment plants. The mucus filters could remove microplastic particles from our wastewater and prevent them from ending up in the water and thus in the environment. Jellyfish are useful, and they are abundantly available. Overfishing reduces the number of fish that eat the jellyfish's food. Overfertilization of farmland washes nutrients into the sea. This causes algae to grow, which is what jellyfish live on. It would still be more ecological not to catch them, but rather to breed them in aquacultures. Alexander Dressel proves that this is possible. He runs Europe's first jellyfish farm near Fulda. A An expert in fish keeping and aquaculture, he worked for large show aquariums for some time. Their problem with the jellyfish is that most of them live for no more than a year. That's how the idea for jellyfish farming came about. Dressel breeds the animals neither for food nor as microplastic filters, but as eye catchers. Our main customers are show aquariums and zoos worldwide. The thing is that jellyfish are seasonal animals and they used to be caught from the sea, and then you could show them for half a year and then the aquarium was empty. We now want to build up the first really big commercial breeding program in Europe here, where we can actually offer the animals all the year round. Alexander Dressel has up to 20 different species and several thousand animals in his jellyfish breeding tanks, a somehow calming, meditative sight. Do you still think it's cool yourself? I mean, you see it every day. Yes, of course. I really like to get up early to come here because I discover something new every day. We're doing a job here. There's almost no literature on it. We see new things. Sometimes we inform other universities. We exchange ideas. And that's super exciting. But what does a jellyfish breeder do? Of course, the animals have to be fed. Most jellyfish eat plankton, tiny algae and sea creatures. Alex feeds them mini crabs. At the age of 6 to 8 weeks, the jellyfish move to their new home. And that doesn't necessarily have to be a zoo. How about a jellyfish for your living room? But you would need a very special aquarium for that, with water currents, and importantly, no corners. Jellyfish are basically plankton, which means they float in open water somewhere in the ocean. There are no corners, no edges, there are no plants they can get caught on, and that's exactly what you have to recreate in the aquarium. And there are already the first jellyfish aquarium customers too. This film and photo agency has had one for a few months now. It's a real eye-catcher. How do people react to it? It's great. They all stop and look. It's a mega eye-catcher, especially in the evening when it's lit up. They stop, look, then knock and ask if they're real or if it's a screensaver. Super cool feedback in any case. And of course, it makes us happy here too. A jellyfish aquarium costs between 350 and 5,000 euros. And depending on the species, you can buy a jellyfish for as little as 25 euros. For science, however, the jellyfish is priceless. Another idea here is jellyfish as fertilizer. That's because they contain phosphate, and plants need this to grow properly. Up to now, their phosphate has come from expensive industrial fertilizers. The ability of jellyfish collagen to store water also has advantages for agriculture. Soils fertilized with jellyfish could hold moisture much better. Many ideas for where and how to use jellyfish are still at the development stage. In the course of their work, scientists and researchers are gaining important knowledge. And yet, we still know relatively little about the jellyfish, even though it was around before the dinosaurs. Who knows what secrets are yet to be discovered about this ancient and remarkable creature?